It's Jace. So last time we did some whispering in Italian, and this time we're going to do a little bit of whispering in Yiddish. So Yiddish, I actually used some of the words growing up and not realized it. If you've ever said Gesundheit to someone who just sneezed, or called someone a maven or a klutz, then you've used Yiddish as well. So Yiddish is a Jewish language. It formed out of, I guess, the Eastern European area centuries ago. And so some of those words have made their way into English. And I'm going to be sharing with you some of my favorite ones. Also, I'm not Jewish myself. I just happen to have used some of the words and not realized it until later on in life. And maybe you'll find some words in here that you've used as well. So here we go. Chutzpah. C H U T Z B A H. Chutzpah. So this means to have courage or gall, even. Usually having the nerve to do something, even unexpected, and it can be either in a positive or a negative connotation. Also, just so you know, many of these words have several different spellings, so the spelling I give you may not be the one that you're used to seeing. All right, let's continue. Kibitz. Kibitz means to chat informally or to give unsolicited advice, like if someone's telling you something that you already know and they know that you already know it. That's kibitzing or kibitzing. The next one is klutz. K L Z. Klutz. This one, this was one of the most common ones that people I know have heard of. It just means a clumsy person, someone that may have lots of scrapes on their arms or knees. A clumsy person, a klutz. The next one is kosher. K O S H E R. Kosher. So this means to prepare food in the traditional Jewish way for the traditional Jewish diet. But usually when I use it, or how I've heard it used, is that you're telling someone that things that were not okay are now okay, or that something's been resolved, that things are cool now. That's kosher. Did you fix that thing? Yeah, everything's kosher now. So, all right. The next one is Maven. 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 Now, a maven is an expert on a particular topic. There's someone that you go to for advice because they specialize in something, perhaps, but basically an expert. A maven. The next one is Mazel Tov. M O Z E L T O V. Mazel Tov. Mazel Tov means congratulations. It can also mean good luck. And I think I read somewhere about how it means being born under the right star or something like that. Next one is Nosh, N O S H, Nosh. And Nosh means to snack on something, either referring to the snack itself or the act of snacking. You just want a little something to nosh on. That's about it. The next one is schlep. S-C-H-L-E-P. Schlep. And schlep means, to me, usually I've heard it refer to someone carrying something on their back or carrying or moving something heavy, either for a long duration or a long distance. To schlep something. Schlep it. The next one is schmooze. And you've probably heard of this one. S-H-M-O-O-Z-E. Schmooze. So I've usually heard this on TV in America. Usually, I guess, primetime television or movies where it's used in a business context. You want to schmooze the customer or schmooze the partner. Either someone that you're trying to sell something to or someone that you work for. Like, you're trying to get a raise or something. So you're trying to schmooze them. Usually because you want something from them. So that's schmooze. Also, schmoozing. You're schmoozing the customer. All right. The next one is schmuck. S-C-H-M-U-K. Schmuck. Schmuck is basically a foolish person or a jerk. And it's definitely meant to be an insult. So, that guy, he's a schmuck. Pretty simple. Alright, the next one. Spiel. S-H-P-I-E-L. Spiel. Usually a long talk, or like a sales pitch. I've heard it used as a sales pitch, mostly, or describing a sales pitch. So, what's his deal? Well, this is his spiel, I guess, you know. This is his thing he's trying to sell you on. But it's usually like I guess it's defined officially as like a long talk or a monologue, perhaps. A spiel. All right. The next one is schmutz. S. C. H. M. U. T. Z. Schmutz. I've also heard this said schmutz, but I'm sure it's different for different people. So schmutz is like you've got some dirt like on your face or on your clothing, or it's like there's a general buildup of grime on something in the kitchen or something. Schmutz. Next one is shtick. S-H-T-I-C-K. Shtick. This is something recognizable about someone that is funny or comical. Something that you'd like if someone had a funny laugh or something, and you recognize them by that. That's their shtick, or something physical, perhaps. A shtick. All right. The next one is one of my favorites. Schwitz. S-H-V-I-T-Z. Schwitz. And that basically means you're sweating a lot. You're exerting yourself a lot. And so you've got the buildup of sweat all over your forehead and back of your neck and stuff. You're schwitzing. Alright, the next one is tukus. And this one's got at least 7 spellings that I know about. I seem to see a different spelling every time I looked up the word, so. Tukus. T U C H U S. tuckus. It basically means your butt, your backside. And that's a tuckus. Associate with either a sort of a grungy person or just someone that isn't very smart, a putz. All right, the next one rhymes with the last one. Futz, F-U-T-Z, futz. And futz means just to mess around with something. There's a glitch in the system. But I don't want to futz around with it. How about that? I used to. All right. And this is the one we talked about at the beginning of the video. Gesundheit. G-E-S-U-N-D-H-E-I-T. Gesundheit. Same way that we would say, bless you, health be with you, kind of, you know, Gesundheit, bless you, right after someone sneezes. So yeah, Gesundheit. The next one you've probably heard of, Lox, L-O-X, Lox. This is a salmon cured with salt, as opposed to smoked salmon. I know I've seen it at a cafe. They served it on top of a bagel with cream cheese. I think it was lox with cream cheese bagel or something like that. But yeah, lox. All right. Another one of those that if you speak English, you've probably heard of this one. Schmo. S-C-H-M-O. Schmo. Basically just means an ordinary or average person, a schmo. And you've heard of Joe Schmo, probably, in the past. That's basically what that means, your average, everyday Joe. Joe Schmo. Alright. And this next one, if you watched Saturday Night Live in the early to mid-90s, you probably saw Mike Myers play an old Jewish lady. One of these skits, I think it was Coffee Talk, and he used the word verklempt a lot. Verklempt. V-E-R-K-L-E-M-P. You're verklempt. So this last one was actually a nickname of a friend, and I didn't realize it was a Yiddish word until I started looking up these other words and verifying their meanings. So this last one is Zoftig. Z O F T I G. Zoftig. And this basically means a full figured man or woman. And yeah, that sort of makes sense. That friend of mine who had the nickname, why that was his nickname. Anyway. So that's that. Those are the Yiddish words that I either grew up with or heard on TV randomly, and they sort of stuck because they're so cool. Yeah. Like I said, I didn't grow up Jewish or anything. I just remember hearing these words and sort of amazed that how they sort of made it into English and became part of the vernacular, at least here in America. So yeah, thanks for watching, thanks for listening, and I'll see you next time.